Mobile automaton tested. This Mod 2 mobile automaton was designed by APL's Adaptive Machines Group with the immediate goal of surviving in the corridors of the Applied Physics Laboratory. It weighs 100 pounds, and into its 19-inch diameter are packed 150 digital logic circuits, batteries, servo loops, and drive motors connected to two of the automaton's four wheels. The automaton survives by feeding or charging its batteries at wall plugs. Micro-switch sensors position the automaton's head so that two prongs can be inserted into the plug receptacle. This console can control and monitor automaton activities. 21 different operational modes, including sleep, feed, free, vibratory, and high and low speed are possible. Information is exchanged over an RF link. The automaton has been turned on, and sensing that its batteries are low, searches for a plug so it can feed. It feeds until its batteries are charged above a preset threshold level. The automaton has, in fact, two goals: to keep moving and to survive. Having just fed, it will keep moving without seeking a wall plug until its battery charge falls below the threshold value. Since the automaton must feed 4 minutes for every one it is free, the value is set to give the automaton a 6-minute free period. It can move 3 hours before its batteries run down. The automaton doesn't learn from its environment, but its circuitry enables it to react in an optimum way to environmental problems. Should the automaton become trapped by obstacles, it automatically shifts to a vibratory mode, during which it radically alters its movement pattern in an effort to escape. Here, the automaton in the free mode passes by a wall plug. Although the automaton is not learning from its environment, its designers are learning from the automaton. They are finding ways to impose sophisticated behavior patterns on electronic circuitry that controls mechanical systems. The techniques being learned with this automaton may prove useful in designing machines to operate in remote areas such as the bottom of the sea and planet surfaces. The Mod 2 mobile automaton is still under development. To its single probing arm are to be added ears and an eye. This circuit board is part of an acoustical system operating at 40 kilocycles that will enable the automaton to maneuver down a corridor without touching the walls. In operation, the system will transmit two side beams, measure return time of reflected energy like a radar, then turn the data into middle-of-the-road steering commands. The optical system will locate and identify wall plugs. Its half-inch Vidicon unit is designed to recognize rectangular objects with a height-to-width ratio of 1.6 to 1, the aspect ratio of the cover plate of a wall plug. As the automaton moves down the corridor, the eye looks out 45 degrees to the right toward the wall. When it sees some object, the optical system moves the automaton in for a closer look. Upon recognizing a cover plate, the system guides the automaton to the plug for feeding.